What's up everybody, Tom here with another video. In today's video, we're talking about the latest stock market news moving the markets right now. We'll also be talking about our technical analysis levels together for the S&P 500, Nasdaq, Bitcoin, gold, silver, and more. A 1% decline for the first trading day of 2021 on the stock market actually has some historical stats that go along with it. What's next for the stock market? Let's find out together. Stay tuned, guys. So as we like to do on this channel, let's get stuck into what's actually going on in the markets right now. And here's a heat map of the S&P 500 for the last day of trade. If we take a look at here, pretty much all of the technology stocks were down, all of the big FANG stocks really copping a hiding, and it was really just Tesla and a few of the defensive stocks that even showed positive kind of results. If we take a look at each one of the markets, we can see here it was pretty much selling straight away into the beginning of the market and then some recovery at the close. But we did have a 1.5% decline for the S&P 500 and Nasdaq for the day. If we take a look at the sectors, only energy was safe with a slight positive. Real estate really got beaten down here, 3.23%. And we also saw utilities and industrials getting beaten up as well with over 2.5% declines there. So the question then becomes, we just started 2021 and we had a 1% drop. How common is this and can it give us any statistical facts about what's going to happen next? Well, actually, there are some statistical facts that go hand in hand with this. It's only happened in all of the trading history of the Dow 18 times. But if we scroll down to the S&P 500, it's only happened 12 times. And when it has happened, it's led to a decline 42% of the time for the rest of the month and the calendar year. Wow, that's pretty interesting. The calendar year has often been negative off the fact that we had a 1% decline at the start of the year. Not crazy high statistical over 50% here, but I'm telling you, there isn't that many years that the stock market is negative overall. So that's pretty crazy. That's 42% of the time it actually declines over the year. Now, let's have a quick look here at what this is meaning and whether there's any statistical facts here. One thing I noticed straight away with these stats is that we're either having a really nice January with like sevens, sixes, kind of probably a 5% average up over these periods, or it's actually a 5% average down. Look at these. There's a big swing here. 5% is quite a lot in the stock market for the month. But if we take a look at the averages here, it seems to be around that point. If we also have a look at all of the other things that are going on in terms of years, we can see here that we had 2001, that was a declining year and also a declining percentage for the first day of the month. So interesting, there's a couple of stats here, 2008, 2016, probably more notably, and we'll be taking a look at that soon, that did show these negative results. Now, what also I find very interesting is that the Nasdaq composite has declined 57% of the time when it's copped over 1% decline on the first trading day of the month. Now that becomes statistically relevant. Nasdaq, 57% of the time, or 4 of the 7 times that it's happened. So we saw here 2016 was the last most relevant kind of case. What happened during 2016 that we can learn from? We'll take a look at that very, very soon. Okay, so what else is really worrying the markets right now? Well, of course, we've got lockdowns throughout the world. We've seen Britain go back down into a partial lockdown here. So a lot of it comes down to this Georgia election. Are we going to have more of the same for the next 4 years in terms of a lot of the policies will still hold, or are we going to have the Democrats in control? So we'll have to see how that plays out, but the stock market will definitely react to that news. And in general, stock markets actually prefer more of the same. So the stock market usually doesn't want sweeping control from any government anytime. They like that kind of stagnation and the ability to just say, okay, we can fix that amount of risk. We don't need to worry about too many policy changes. So the Georgia election is certainly something that many people will be watching in the US right now from a perspective of stock market investments as well. If we also talk about what's going to be happening for the year ahead, now, this is the first time the S&P 500 has had a negative since 2016, as I mentioned before. And what that will end up meaning is something very interesting. What happened in 2016 that possibly could happen again? Well, let's take a look at that. Well, let's take a look at that now. Let's have a look here at the SPX, and then we'll go to the daily, and we'll go through to 2016. So if we scroll through here all the way back to 2016, what we'll notice is that we did have some declining market coming into the end of 15. Then we had 16 and we had that decline come through, and the decline went for all pretty much of January into February. So we ended up having basically it signaling the start of a January-February sell-off, followed by, of course, very nice bullish movement into the end of the year. Will this year be the same as that? Will we see a declining market here coming through January into February and then, of course, bulling into the rest of the year? Well, that certainly could be very probable or possible considering how high the market is right now. And of course, some of the stocks that people are starting to question whether they're necessarily worth that much. I think many of you would know that we're very bullish on this channel in terms of longer term or medium term, but sometimes markets do get overinflated. And possibly since the November kind of bull run, we are ready for a bit of a 38.2 to 50 Fibonacci pullback, something in that kind of realm. So very interesting times there for the market in terms of what's going on. So before we go into any further stock market analysis, let's just quickly talk about some of the other markets going on right now, as there's been some massive moves in the last 24 hours. We have here the dollar index. The dollar index was looking pretty shaky yesterday, and then all of a sudden we saw a big bull movement here, almost wiping off all of yesterday's loss. We got as low as 89.42 and then rebounded all the way back up here to almost 90 again for the dollar index. We still really maintain the 20 moving average exponential is the key point here for this dollar index, but we'll be watching this kind of rebound and seeing what's going on here over the next couple of days. If we go over to Bitcoin, Bitcoin continued its massive run since Sunday's video, and we can see that it went all the way upwards just under 35,000, as it likes to do. Those 5 and 10,000 increments specifically right now are very important. And then it had one of Bitcoin's normal, very normal flash crash events. Now, look how fast this flash crash event was purchased up. This is what happens. They often go about 20 to 30% down. This one was just around 20%. And we did see huge buying pressure coming back into the market just above that 20 exponential moving average, which is something that we've signaled before based on previous touches. We had previous touch here, previous touch here. So Bitcoin went down quite substantially. It went down from 34,800 all the way down to 27,800. And then now it's trading back at $32,800. So what's next for Bitcoin? Well, look, it may go and crack a new high. It may go towards possibly 40,000. Remember, if we get through 35, where's it going to gravitate to? The next 5,000 number. We're going to go probably towards 40,000. However, because of the nature of this sell-off, because of usually what happens with Bitcoin around this time, we've seen the rise of altcoins. Things like Ethereum had massive runs on them. Look at this. Ethereum is trading at 1,112 at the time of recording of this video. That's now only about $400 off its previous highs here. We've got here 1560 as a previous high, and the market's certainly trying to look for that. So it's gone past our expectations of $800 and blown through the $1,000 quite easily, and now it's trading at $1,100. So Ethereum is incredibly, incredibly bullish right now, super far away from all of the key moving averages, things like the 20 moving average and the 50. And it's basically on the FOMO train. Now, I want to warn everybody, when these FOMO trains usually break down, we always see 20 to 30% quick bust. Just like we saw with Bitcoin yesterday, usually a 20 to 30% bust is in order whenever you get these kind of moves. Now, the further this goes up, let's say it goes to 1500, the bust will still be around 20 or 30% of that particular thing, and it will happen usually within 24 to 48 hours. It happens incredibly quickly on these cryptocurrencies. So what's next for these? Well, it's still bullish for now. The only way you can really look at these types of things is to go to the smaller time frames and try to recognize things like moving averages or key levels that you're interested in, or things like price action where you get reversals like this. Wick rejection, wick rejection, wick rejection. What's that telling us? It's telling us there's bullish buyers here. And every time it tries to come down, the buyers are just ramming it back up there into the 20 moving average. So this was probably a very good buy zone here for anyone that got it yesterday. Very nice and well done to those Ethereum traders. And you can see the results that are happening right now. It is a FOMO market right now. People are FOMOing It's very similar to 2017. So please be careful out there if you're considering trading these pairs right now. Let's go over some of our favorites as well. Let's talk about gold. So gold absolutely did what we thought it would do. It got up to that 1930 as soon as it got through that 1900. Nice bullish movement, perfect, just as we expected it to do. Now that's through 1930 as well, we probably expect a little bit of a pullback here and then hopefully a movement back up to the 1960 resistance zones. If we actually zoom this out, you'll see why we've got that 1960 previous resistances over here and of course the previous resistance before it sold off quite heavily back in November. So gold's looking really great. We look at it on a weekly, things are really making sense here. And I think a break of 1960 is going to signal tests of the previous highs. So I like what we're seeing here on gold. Silver, probably my more favored commodity right now, moving very, very nicely. We've got some prices up here on silver. Silver basically went and tested the previous 2740 highs, had a very nice little run up there. As soon as it broke through that zone as well, we talked about, it was just great trading. Check out this. This is really nice. And this is what I hope a lot of you are starting to see in the markets right now. Previous resistances were taken out with the Monday open. Great. We saw the follow through effect of bullish movement then a sell off back down to the 1-2-3. Just as we said on the channel, go check our weekend video on silver. We're talking about this 1-2-3. This area or this zone acting as a really great buy area if it broke through and closed and confirmed above. It certainly did. Great little zone there. Congratulations to anyone that was getting them. And that's just technical analysis in action. The 1-2-3, many things we talk about in this channel all the time coming into play. And of course, the key is reading the price action, understanding that market psychology. Market structure is always key to us as technical traders. Take a look at US oil. US oil is really kind of having those OPEC woes. We didn't see them really come to much of an agreement here. We see the sell-off almost tap that $50, which is pretty much exactly what we were targeting for. So 50 to 51 was the target here, all the way since pretty much $41 down here is what our target was. And we can see that's coming back down to test this 20, but I've got this line drawn through 46. And I've done that because I think that if oil here, US oil that is, gets through this zone, it's going to signal some pretty big selling pressure. And the selling pressure is at least going to go down to 44, if not potentially all the way back down to 42 or something like that. Basically, this is the problem. The problem is that if we do get under this, what are we doing? We're breaking the previous trough, we're breaking the previous resistance and support, so the roll reversal area, and we're creating a little double top on the smaller time frames. So be careful with oil right now in the markets, as I think OPEC can always do whatever they feel like, but at the same time, it is a manipulated instrument for sure. So if you get through there, it could be signaling further bearish pressure on oil for now. So many of you would know that the Nasdaq has been one of my kind of pairs that I'm looking at right now to show me whether the market is becoming bearish or it's still in a nice bullish trend. We saw the 20 exponential moving average hold for the first day of trade for 2021. This is what happened, basically a full bunch of bullish pressure coming through the 20, buying pressure again yesterday coming back in, and we really maintain that if this 20 exponential is closed below, that's going to be the signal that's going to push us probably back down to these previous highs at around 12,150, so basically push us back down here and of course bring the rest of the market with us. The tech is usually leading the market right now. And if the tech starts to show the weakness and close underneath the 20, that's going to be my signal. If you get a new high, of course, what does that really signal? Back to 13,200 or a new all-time high at 13,200 and the completion of this range that we've been going for some time. So for now, bulls are still in control, but the 20 has been under pressure over the last 24 hours. Same on the US 500. If we take a look here, the 20 is also holding it up. The wicks are more severe through this particular one, but you can see again, there are traders buying this pressure. So 3,700 has been purchased and the futures trading is slightly up as at the time of recording of this video. Another thing that we might be able to see here is there's probably a trend line coming through, I would say on the smaller time frames here for this particular pair. Basically, you could put it through these last three peaks and you could say, well, if it does come back up, possibly there'll be some resistance every time it hits this price until maybe it does roll over. So the US 500 is one we're watching. And of course, it's all about the news right now. Check out, of course, what's going on in Georgia and check out what's going on in the rest of the world. But as we like to say, let the price action tell us what the opportunities are for us as traders and investors. All right, guys. Well, if you enjoyed this video, please remember to subscribe and, of course, hit that alert bell. And we'll see you in the next video. Again, I'd just like to thank everyone for the support over 2020. And we've got some big plans for January, February, and the rest of the year on this channel moving forward. See you in the next video, guys. Bye for now.